this afternoon. Thank you again, President Nygren, for joining us as we go downstairs. I know this has been one of your favorite events all week long. It's the Wild Horse Race. Andy, it's going to be exciting.
Yes, it will. We have 8 teams to compete. First, we have from Shonto, Arizona, Team BGB. From Shonto, Arizona as well, Team Chizzy. From Warm Springs, Oregon, Team Get You Some. And from Fort Defiance, Arizona, 3 Bar N. From Topola, Arizona, Team Swagamaw. From Warm Springs, Oregon, Team Von Garcia. From Oregon, we welcome the Super Ranch. And from Thoreau, New Mexico, the Gibson Boys.
All right, Window Rock, we are ready. Follow along. They've all got their shirts on. A 2-minute time limit. Let's count it down from 5, 4, 3. Here we go, the Wild West coming alive on Championship Sunday. Jones Brothers Wild Horses taking it to them today. There you see our boys in the blue. They're looking to get it on. Team Von Garcia. Nope, that's the green, rather. Team BGB let a horse get away. Von Garcia in the center of the arena trying to get their horse saddled by the barrel. In the brown, there is Team Swagamaw. Got a saddle on, they're tightening a cinch. Swagamaw on the back of the horse, here we go. They've got a ride between the barrel and the fence as they look to be the first team to do it today. I love the war whooping lookout. Wow, the boys in red is the Super Ranch. They're on the back of the gray. A galloping ghost trying to get to the west end of the arena. Oh, we're going southbound in the corner. Your boys in blue, Team Von Garcia finally crossed the line. Look out, Charlie Brown coming down. Yellow shirt is Team Get You Some. Only 2 teams crossed today. Wow, Team Swagamaw in 1, Von Garcia in 2. Andy, what a great way to start the rodeo.
Oh my gosh. That right there by itself is worth the price of admission. And at the end of the day, it's all about survival.
You cross a wild horse roundup in a barroom brawl.
Well,
it looks
that's
something
right.
Like this.
This is one of those roundups where the men are feral and the horses aren't nearly as wild.
Look at them. They're tired. They're beat up. They're worn out. They look like they just changed the baby's diaper that was fighting.
As we try to get all of our guys lined up so we can make a wall.
Back around they come.
Get everybody back in the left lead. There we go.
All right, Window Rock. On the count of 3, everybody go, yeah, give us your best little hoop there. 1, 2, 3. There it is. Be part of the roundup today. Great job to our crew out of the Enchantment Physical Therapy Gate. Give them all a round of applause, the Wild Horse Racers today. Thank you to the Jones Brothers, bringing us those great wild horses, our partners, Elevation Gaming Enterprise, TNR Feed Road, Rico Auto Complex, for all they do.
First competition you will see, it is steer wrestling time. State of Missouri, Mr. Dustin the Jester Jenkins.
What do you want me to do with the barrel?
Nothing. We got it handled.
Olin, hey, they forgot the barrel. Can I have it?
I was hoping Olin something. Would just tackle you on the way and give us a steer wrestling demonstration.
No, no. Hey, so I got a team I want to enter next year for the wild horse race.
Okay.
You do?
My father-in-law and my mother-in-law.
Who's the third member?
My wife, I guess. I don't know. It would work out real well, right?
Yeah.
No.
So you're saying your in-laws are tougher than you?
Yeah. Yeah, that's exactly right.
I thought Jim told you to come out ready with some jokes.
Yeah, and I just throw a, like a little sideways
there. That one went over like a lead balloon.
Yeah, they were laughing, right? Y'all like your mother-in-law and father-in-law, don't you?
No, see, that lady's on my side, right there. Thank you.
She's not sitting next to you, is she?
Well, our steer wrestling starts off in a big way with an all-around contender, Coyote Canyon, New Mexico. Cowboy, you're going to see twice. Ayoyazi is not only in the steer wrestling, but he will also be in the team roping as well. Qualified with a 5.1 second run, your top four steer wrestlers all had two down. So he will try to win some day money to give him a shot at the all-around. We'll also have somebody in the rough stock competition we'll introduce to you in a little bit that has a shot at that all-around trailer.
Almost comes down to the wire today. Pair of cowboys, pair of cowgirls, here we go. Come on, Hyo makes the jump, yeah! Showing you why he's the Grand Canyon Region All-Around Champion of College Rodeo. How about a four flat today?
You know why I'm hot?
The what? Sun is up.
This is why I'm hot.
But you're not.
Oh, yeah, I am. See, ladies?
Stop it, aunties. You don't want none of that.
Yeah, don't enable him, please. Chase Crane coming all the way from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, to be at the nomination fair this year. A 4.6. He was one of our faster runs in the long round. There you go. Get him down with a 3.8 today.
Picture perfect.
These are like professionals, right? Are they professional people?
Yes.
I like being professional.
When did that happen?
Last week. Right last week.
Okay. Yeah, that was my bad. There's no trailer to the all-around, just the saddle. But very nice saddles to all of our champions.
Absolutely beautiful saddle. Teske saddle valued at about $4,500. Custom handmade. They're beautiful. They're on display by the entrance.
We did give away a trailer last night, so the Freudian slip is all on me. I'll take it.
Thank you, Navajo Oil and Gas.
Jeremiah Jody. World champion cowboy, looking at two very tough times in front of him with a 3.8 and a 4 flat. Resets the black horse, takes a step forward, eases back into the shadows. Oh! But just like a Dallas Cowboys pass, he's over the head of the intended receiver.
That happens always, every Sunday.
This rodeo has won the fastest on three. They all ran one on Wednesday. The fastest of the field got into the performances Thursday to last night. The fastest 8-on-2 are here with us right now. Trying to win the rodeo, the fastest on three. Rooster Yazzie comes to us as the fourth of our guys that are here holding one steer. As Andy said, they're only after the money today. Come on, Rooster! Yeah! 4.4 is time today.
I've got a challenge for you, Dustin.
So do I. People are stealing the stage. What are they doing?
No, they're breaking it down. Here's your challenge of the day.
Okay.
I want you to find the best tent umbrella combination.
Check it out. Who's got the best? Come on, make some noise. You got the best tent?
Oklahoma City's Johnny Jones. That is a big boy. Stout Cowboy, the first one you will see this afternoon that qualified on two head.
14 second gap between the number one and the number four man. And your aggregate coming in here today. Help the Oklahoma talent get him down. Yeah. The stature works in his favor in a 4.9 for Johnny Jones, 4.9.
Bring him to the house. 4.6.
Bring him down there, Andy. As our time comes in. I got to keep up with the puns with this guy. I'm loving it. 4.6.
Previante Fulbright. 10-4 on two. Stares in between the ears of that horse. waiting for his opportunity to go full steam ahead. We got one caught. And over 5.5. He will also advance to our final four round.
You're looking at a 3.8 in the short round, 15.9, I believe, so far. And the number one spot in your aggregate race. As we go to Church Rock, New Mexico now. College national finalist, the number one man, Matthew Jody. He's on a 9.3, so he's got a little time to work with here today. Look at that.
That's the umbrella hat combo.
Haven't seen one of those in a while.
You got it at a flea market. So they don't even make those anymore.
Here we go, Matt Jody, the number one man, sister on the Hazen side, to the nose and down. And a 5.1 going to be our time today. 5.1 takes us to a 14.4. That is going to be your fastest on three. And your champion of the Navajo Nation Fair Rodeo in 2000.
This is one of the events that we will sell in the Calcutta in just a little bit. So we will show you that leaderboard to give you the top four that will advance into our championship round as we say thank you to CKP Insurance and the banner of the Navajo Nation Fair. There is your champion, Matthew Jody of Church Rock, New Mexico.
I hope you brought cash because the Calcutta is back after nearly 20 years of absence. So in riding right now, we're going to sell these guys too, so watch closely as we start you off with Lyle Thomas. Indian Wells, Arizona on a Raptor G horse called Hard Times. We're inside shoot number one today, CKP Insurance. Good afternoon to all of our VIPs joining us all around the arena today. CKP Insurance, the Mid Development Corporation, Navajo Nation Gaming Enterprise, and Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department, the portals on the north side.
We welcome back our pickup man, Dalton Barnes, Glenn Hale, and Skeet Abbott, taking care of our cowboys and our livestock.
All right, we'll get you rolled over right now. We take you over to shoot number two. Go to Tom Chi of Newcomb, New Mexico on a Steve Smith bucking horse, Andy.
Challenger, the name of the draw. And that's what he hopes to be. He's qualified here on two head, but he's going to need a very good ride to climb that ladder and qualify to our final four.
No stranger to bringing his fighting shoes to town. He's an all-around cowboy. Any rodeo we go to, he's a bareback riding, saddle bronc riding bull rider that has qualified to our India National Finals Rodeo. Shoot number two, Next Era Energy.
That's a cool-looking hat, too.
Oh, yeah.
Speaking of hats, we're going to be giving away a Resistol a little bit later on to our fan of the afternoon. Tommy Lloyd, show us what you got.
Oh, he is turning it. Oh, ouch. He was fixing to turn it on. How about something for the cowboy T.R.Y. today? It's a no score.
And it is going to be a no score for Tom. We travel back to Indian Wells, Arizona. And Lyle Thomas now has everything set and ready to go in the CKP Insurance Bucket Shoot. We gather up the horse, get him outside the Enchantment Physical Therapy Center alleyway. Lyle Thomas.
That horse just moseying on out. It's that Sunday vibe.
It's Sunday afternoon, right?
He put on a show in the arena. He's like, yeah, I'm bad. I'll take my time.
Hard Times! And Lyle embodies that. It will be a no-score
round race. As we get ready to look at the four guys that have a shot at winning the title, there's about a 21.5 point split between number one and four. Here's Wyatt Batoni, got a shot at the all-around. Sumo for Stace Smith. Oh, yes. From the very start all the way to the 8 second mark, Wyatt came to win. A big explosion right there. Snappy kicks to the shoulder every single ride. Staying right down the center of the horse as the score comes in to a 76 point today.
To defend their title, Whistle Joe. Whistle Joe of Round Rock, Arizona. Our pickup men circle around with Chocolate Bay.
You hear the fan section here. They know what they want to see. They know their favorites. They know the caliber of cowboys.
That's right.
This Calcutta is going to be pretty wicked to watch, Andy.
And they don't want to see you, Dustin, just in case you're wondering. Whistle Joe, money changer, the Stace Smith horse underneath the Southpaw athlete. Get to riding him, cowboy! Time circle around to the left. Now you as the fans get to watch this replay and compare notes. How much control did your defending champ have? How much kick did the horse give out the back? Our judges say that Wyatt did it better than Whistle. 67 points for Whistle Joe.
Bareback rider on a horse called Singer from St. Smith. We're going down below chute number five. This is the chute number six, rather, Navajo Nation Shopping Centers Incorporated. They've got locations all around the Navajo Nation and invite you to visit one near you. Matthew Tooney has made appearances at the College National Finals Rodeo. He's one of our premier talents in the bareback, helping Arizona Cowboy right now, Window Rock. He has strong mark out, trying to hold his own against a big Stace Smith bucket horse to the 8 second mark. Ooh, look out. The rescue boys are trying to get a rope on that horse. Trying to bring him to a stop. 70 points today, 7-0. There you see him get contained. The bullfighter's trying to get in the mix. As we look to get another loop on him.
Trying to get that cowboy to his feet. That is the most important thing. So he can get that hand out of the rigging. Folks, if you will, how about you give our crew a round of applause? Contender in the bareback riding. Tonalea, Arizona's Evan Batoni. An INFR cowboy on a paint horse called the Joker. Only needs 64 points to go to the lead. BRCA cowboy. I think this young man has an Indian World title in his future. As the horse circles around, you take a look back. Watch how it's supposed to be done. He goes to the top spot by nearly 10 points. 73 for Evan Batoni.
Wow, by 10 and our partners at the Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department. Four spirited casinos with Navajo gaming. One legendary story. More excitement. One of our legendary talents of the Navajo Nation, Farmington, New Mexico. Get him down, tied, and wrapped up today. Come on, Marvin. Yeah. Just like you said, they're wanting to put pressure on the top four guys.
Wait, what are those guys doing?
That is the untie crew. They help untie the calf and let him go.
They're in pursuit, little black calf to the center of the arena. Down the line we go, lift him over on the ground, string the front, cross the back. Fast hands, try to go to work. Thorough tie today in a 14-6. Russell Jackson.
Russell's got some fans over there on the southwest side. Anybody here this afternoon at your first rodeo ever? First timers, where you at? Again, we will be rewarding our Resist All fan of the afternoon. A brand new hat, courtesy of Raptor G Rodeo and the Navajo Nation. Thank you to Resist All for helping us out with that. Garrison spins around and back to the corner.
Stuffer, this is two-step.
There you go. I heard you were causing problems in the big white tent last night.
I did. It was fun.
Come on, Garrison. Help one of our veteran talents win the rock right here. Yeah. Time going to be 11-8. By the way.
All right, I got to watch these guys. This looks fun.
Yep. Right. We've got the Big Chief and the Pillow Warrior. You weren't even paying attention. Yeah. Yeah. Let Olin do the heavy lifting.
Yeah, he's going to. I'm going to do the. Yep. I got this.
Navajo Harrison, Chinle, Arizona. Got the little red calf, flank, string, gather, and tie. 11-4, the fastest time we've seen this afternoon in the tie down roping. Things are starting to heat up now.
Nelson Charlie III, one of our young gun talents, in pursuit down to the end. We got to make up a little time here on the tie today. Watch him. He is after it on a Sunday. Oh! 13-4 in the round. You know when you get to looking for your keys?
Rodeo. We've seen him grow up.
Already punched his ticket to India National Finals Rodeo in hot pursuit. Come on, Noah. He's your third fastest on two so far. Let's keep the momentum going. Got him gathered. String tie, you bet. 11-1 for Noah. 11.1. That's going to be your fastest in the round in the 35 flat. Your fastest on three.
So smooth, too. I mean, when you watch this replay, no mistakes once he gets to the cab. Handles, strings, gather, tie, all of that, just flawless. Great way to end it out. And Malachi Pablo.
You're kind of creepily looking at that, watching him untie.
I'm acting like Butch. I'm the judge over the untie. Yes. You just sit there and watch the whole time. And then you go, good job.
Get you a white shirt.
Yeah. I'll put a vest on.
21 flat. That is the time for Malachi coming in. It's about 2.5 seconds away from the top spot. But all he wants to do at this point in time is make a solid run, put himself in a shot to get to our shootout round. Oh! There is the one.
Rodeo. Dontre Goff is in position to win the Navajo Nation Fair. He's got a good 16-4 to play with. Here this afternoon, but you know it's Sunday. It's Sunday afternoon, the legendary Navajo Nation Fair. He wants to put the exclamation mark on the run. When you come in on an 18.6 on two head, that means you were fast. You were under 10 seconds both times. As you watch him waste no time to get out of the box today. Come on, Dontre, smooth step down to the calf. Now watch his hands go to work. Fast hands, exclamation mark. And an 11.7, 11.7 in the round. That's going to take us at a 30.3. 30.3, your aggregate champion of the Navajo Nation Fair Rodeo. Your fastest time in the round today, 11.1. But that man right there.
What a open. In the breakaway roping. Game Jody. Church Rock, New Mexico.
A talent who's no stranger to Sunday Funday in this arena. After a title here at the Nomination Fair. Backs in, cool, calm, ready to go to work. She's exactly 2 seconds behind your number one cowgirl. It is going to be an absolute knife fight to get into the championship position today. If you haven't seen them already, the saddles are on display from our great partners and sponsors. The each valued at $4,500. You can win one yourself absolutely free. Just pick up a blue ticket at the entrance area. There's our run today, a 4.2 from Rodeo. 4.2 takes us to a 12.8 on three. Andy, your first cowgirl to get three times turned in the nomination fair in the Breakaway.
That just keeps everybody on point, New Mexico. Beautiful blue roan horse underneath her. Roan paint of all things. Oh! It does not fall on. No time for Artesia.
Oh, anything can happen in the championship round. Anything can happen. One of our fan favorite talents from the legendary DeHosey family of rodeo from Fort Defiance, Arizona. A former all-around champion of this very rodeo. Serena. Got money on her mind today. 8-3 on two. Calling for the calf. Come on, Serena. Yeah! Let it lay, let it pay at a 3.9. Serena. In the hunt, 3-9.
She's a 9-time world champion. Not only an Indian world champ, she is a national finals qualifier in the barrel race. Miss Cassidy Dennison. She's had success at every level. A collegiate standout. An all-around cowgirl from a rodeo family. See if we can keep it going in the breakaway. Yes, ma'am! And just like that, 4.4. And 12-3
total. Oh, yeah. She did good. Oh, that's not good. Oh, that's terrible. She didn't do very good. Are you okay? She's all right. She's good. She wants to clap. Yeah.
I wish she would just walk.
I look like Vanilla Ice.
Here's Aaron Sells. Totally at Arizona, 7-3. 0.7 seconds behind the number one is in your top three coming to us. From all of our contenders over the run of the Navajo Fair Rodeo, Aaron calling for it. Oh no, it's gonna be a no time. We're looking for what we call a clean neck catch. Passing the nose, ears breaking clean around the neck of the cow. No time.
All right,
Vanilla.
Marcel Jones! No time for Marcella. I hate it when your microphone just stops working right during the middle of a song.
Andy probably touched it too.
No, I made a request, special request.
Yeah.
Let's go to Tonalita, Arizona right now as we ride in with the cowgirl who's the fastest on two hit. We just saw the number two contender go out as a young gun talent, Autumn Farland, is in position to win the Navajo Nation Fair Rodeo. Just under 6 seconds to work with today. Blazing red calf takes her down to the end of the pin. We got him stuck on in a 5-flat today. 5.0, 11-6 on three. Say hello to your champion of the Navajo Nation Fair Rodeo. Wow. Doesn't get any better than that. 11-6, gonna make her your champion this year, but we're gonna do it right. Window Rock on behind the banner of the Navajo Nation Fair and CKP Insurance. Autumn Farland, your champion cowgirl.
I wanna know from each and every one of you. Arizona, be the first cowboy to try it. Navajo Nation Shopping Center bucket shoot. Delta Dawn, little tip of the cap to Tanya Tucker. This is a short round horse, one that we've had in the championship round before. Raptor G, your stock contractor of record. Bringing in some of our friends like Stay Smith, DNC Pro Rodeo, and Rudy Vena. Reach back, Joe Shane, get it done! Keep spurring, buddy! But we got some bad news. A Let's watch this replay. First jump out of the chute, you got to keep your feet above the horse's shoulders. And there you see the right foot fall down. So it will be a no score for Mr. Key, no score for Shoshane.
That's what I'm down feeling every time they run past me.
What scares you?
I get over here by the fence and clutch on it like a little bear. You know? Then they run beside me and it scares me because I think I'm going to get kicked. You'll catch me, right? Okay. All right.
There you go. Get those hands going. The noise, the energy, the excitement you bring helps our cowboys ride. We're in the chute with Llewellyn Paul of Shiprock, New Mexico. Misfit out of the cellular one bucket chute and a hard, hard, hard landing. In the D.C. Jackson Memorial Arena today, it's going to be a no score.
Our pickup men, Pendleton Juan Mills and Chad Phillips. Hawk Arizona road rage the horse.
Yikes.
Look, the horse won't leave him alone. I mean, talk about adding insult to injury. The horse not only bucks him off, he has a little road rage himself and wants to run him over.
Well, it's absolutely bad. Lyle Thomas of Indian Wells, Arizona. Dry Gulch, the name of the horse of State Smith Pro Rodeo. Chute number two is where we take you over to Next Era Energy. Arizona, that's a little interesting word. Yeah, flair, here we go. Wow! Exploded out of there. You see the re-ride?
Yeah, don't I look good?
No.
Why?
Men wearing women's items never look good.
That's exactly right. Okay, I'll pick up the bat.
College National Finalist State Rigs, Tuba City, Mud Creek. Oh! Slam him down.
Oh, fucking shoots. Navajo Nation Shopping Center. That is Shane Phillips. Hawk Arizona and a horse named Blue Velvet. Blue Velvet the horse. They tightened up the back cinch. It's a 7-point difference between Shane and the world champion that will follow him. So he's gonna try to press on. See if he can make it more difficult for the next man you're gonna watch to defend his title.
You know, it's so interesting, Andy, as we wind down to your final two, there's only a 7-point split between the number one and the number two man. You talk about a knife fight with two cowboys who have the talent. They've got the great, great bucking horse talent to do it as well. It's gonna be some phenomenal watching of the next two rides.
Got his hat back on. Saddle is set and ready. As Shane climbs the board. Puts his feet in those stirrups. Rain is in the right hand. Lean back, let's go to work! Blue Velvet, the beautiful gray! And Shane does his job to a T. First cowboy to go 4-for-4. As we set him down, you pick him up. I think you're gonna like this. 78 points for Shane Phillips. Total odds has got something to shoot at.
Oh boy, I told you it was gonna heat up in a big time way. Your final man, there you see him, cool, calm, collect, CC Rider. The defending champion of this rodeo has to be 72 or better. But he's got a great, great equine partner underneath him. The dance between Handsome Jack and Handsome CC is fixing to light up the D.C. Jackson on a Sunday afternoon. Thank you to Chapman Physical Therapy taking care of our outgame as the Arizona Cowboy climbs aboard a Texas bucket horse from State Smith. Former champion of the world and the defending champion, Creighton Curley of Ganado, Arizona. He is center stage in shoot number 5 from Sunk Construction today. To take the lead in the round's got to be a 79. Take the lead in the aggregate has to be a 72. Come on, Window Rock. Come on, Creighton Curley and a big flashy paint horse from Steve Smith Pro Rodeo. To the 8-second mark, makes him look easy on Sunday Funday. We set him on the ground. How do you like C.C. Ryder? Exclamation mark on his back-to-back victory. 81 and a half in the round. That'll take us 302.5 on 4. He's your back-to-back champion at the Navajo Nation Fair. How about it for Creighton Curley one more time? That is why we buy tickets to the rodeo. Generations from now, you can tell them, I was there when C.C. Ryder won it back-to-back behind the banners of Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department and the Navajo Nation Gaming Enterprise. How about it one more time for your Saddle Bronc Riders today?
Back-to-back team roping. First, we start with the All-Rally Arizona, where our first team will come from. Top 6 qualified in this event. We get our judge horseback and ready to go.
So, I figured out what sash that I need to be wearing.
What kind of?
It's not as pretty as, you know. It's not as pretty as hers, but...
Oh, you're just going to wear a flank strap?
Yeah, what do y'all think? Does it look good? Uh-uh. Does this look better? I'm looking right at you. No?
No.
She said put it back, put hers back on.
Yeah.
So, it's nice.
Mackley Williams and Alicia Keene. Two horns, 2 feet is what we'd like. Half a hand, that's legal, that'll work. He will catch one hind leg. That's nearly up in face. Get the ropes tight. There we go. It'll be a 22-1 with a 5-second penalty.
Kylie Gilbert and Lene Willie. Farmington to Mexico on the head side, Magdalena to Mexico to the heels. 13-3. Put them about 5.5 seconds behind your number one team. You start seeing your big contenders make their way in. Kylie Gilbert, one former all-around champion of the world at Indian National Finals Rodeo from the legendary Gilbert family. Lene Willie backed in on the heel side. There we go, slick horns. Lene on the corner. There you are, Dally, stretch, face, 5 in the field, 11-2, going to be our time today, 11-2. Take us to a 24-5 on 2.
Well, flat on their first one, Destiny and Resenda. Seen how it's done, now we want to do more of it. Slick around the horns. Oh yeah, we got another one. B16 flat with a 5-second penalty. 16 flat, 28 flat on 2.
See what's popping with Renee Malala and Callie. 4.5, your fastest on 2 so far. 11-2, the fastest of the round. Kayenta, Arizona. Where these ladies come from. There we are. Now, bring them around on the corner and 2. Oh no. We lose it and in no time today.
And Jocelyn Donacini of Winslow, Arizona. Debbie, the all-around cowgirl who has a title in the breakaway roping. They smoked it on him in round one with an 8-3. Slow Steer takes a step to the right. We got him on the horns. Can we get him on the back? Yes, we can! Just like that. Figure eight in the back feet. Travis says, I like it. We do too. 9.3. There's your number one team. 17-6. For all of you with a calculator.
Wow, the ladies' team roping never disappoints in this arena. Just under 10 seconds to work with as we ride in with Lacey K. Begay of Window Rock, Arizona, and Tammy Big Thumb Justin of Maricopa. Wasting no time to get out of there. Lacey, oh no, the number one team goes out. Andy, we've been saying it all day long. Anything can happen in the championship round.
Strange things happen on the final day of events like this, especially when it's a championship round. But the team, Conocini, the Winslow duo will take the title behind the banner of Navajo DOT. And of course, our friends that have been with us at Navajo Arts and Crafts Enterprise, give it up one more time for Debbie and Jocelyn. There are your champions.
Olin Begay of Flagstaff, Arizona, Shane Begay of Pinon, starting us off. We say thank you, of course, to Chapman Physical Therapy, our friends at Dibble, Brown & Associates, and Molina Healthcare. Premier partners, thank you to CKB Insurance, Navajo Nation Gaming Enterprise, the Navajo Corporation, Navajo DOT, and the Navajo Arts and Crafts Enterprise. Our appreciation going out to the 25th Navajo Nation Council, Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company as well. Just right. The header, the healer, their horses, and the steer. All got to be on the same page. We call for it and make our way down. Oh, no. Only got one horn and we do it. It's going to be a no time. There you go. I like it.
Staring down. Justin wants the chance to throw that loop out. We got him on the front. Brooks, he's got him. 5-9. 5-7, even faster. 22-3. 22-3, unofficially. Putting them down in the
number top eight round. Keep in mind, team roping is one of our events today in the Calcutta. Dwight Sells, Cody Lansing, the reigning champion of the world on the healing side. Slip a leg with a 5-second penalty, 13-4. Our total time today, 13-4 in the round. And the aggregate race takes us
15-1 up to this point. Good turn. We'll catch only one hind leg, 11-1. 11-1, making them 26-2. Officially puts them number two.
Come on, everybody, clap along. Come close on a 14 flat. 1.8 seconds behind the number one team. Lead in the aggregate is a 22-3 on three so far. In pursuit we go. Got him on the horns, two on the back. What do we have? You bet. You bet. Clean run, 6-4. 6-4, 20.4. On three, they go.
They're moving on with only three teams left. Yazzie. Ohio, like we talked about at the top of the show, has a shot at that all-around saddle as well. He can continue to collect checks as the day moves forward. Dennis Begay to the horns. Prem Hall and Coyote Canyon, New Mexico. Martinez with a nod of the head. Levin Gray puts him in a spot. Oh! 5.8. That is now your number one team. 19-5. Unofficially, once you put it all together, 19-5, and they will be moving on.
12.5, they're 0.3 seconds behind the number one team. I hope you're watching close for the Calcutta. The legend on the heel side, you bet. And a clean run, 5.4. 5.4 takes us to a 17.9. They lead the aggregate race. And I believe lead your round as well.
Blaine Red Horse and Casey Cummins. They were 6-6 last night to qualify to the top spot. They came in with a 0.3 lead on the field. So that means 5-6 to take the title all by their lonesome. Hind open steer, Casey Cummins will rope one hind leg. Would have been 5-5, and that would have been a title, but 10-5 once we add it all together. That means that the second to last team, Doyle, oh, what a great team roping it was this afternoon.
Oh, it surely did not disappoint. There you see it. Doyle Yazzie, Victor McGay. Victor's going to win this rodeo back-to-back, 17-9. Dennis McGay, Hyo Yazzie in the number two spot for the 19-5. Brendan Tallman, Tyler Sam, 20.4. Justin Tom, Brooks DeHosey, round out your top four. There you come with the victory lap. How about it for Doyle Yazzie and Victor McGay? We're going to sell your top 14.
What a great audience you have been. Before we get to our final timed event competition in the 8th round, we want to bring in a group of ladies that carry on a tradition that dates back to the days of the Old West, when art and athleticism would come together. The danger, the athleticism, all of that combined so that these cowgirls can perform for you. Please help us in welcoming, all the way from Lovington, New Mexico, the Boyd family. Here comes Miss Summer Boyd and her trusty mount, Smokey.
Let's go, girls.
She has brought along her two daughters. Here is 8-year-old Emmy Boyd riding Shorty. And the youngest member of the family, here is 5-year-old Jensen Boyd riding Glam. These are your trick riding cowgirls. As they make their way in front of the grandstand, they are set up and ready to go. Miss Summer will lead the way with the first trick she wants to show you. This is called the backbreaker. All the way over, holding on with just the equipment she has, trusting her horse to put her in position. Let's make welcome Miss Summer Boyd. Now it's 8-year-old Emmy. It is time to show you the Indian Hideaway. Come on, folks, as she comes in front of you, let's give it up for the 8-year-old lady. Here comes 5-year-old Jensen with a Stroud layout. Friends, she is only 5 years old. As she comes in front of you, let her feel at home.
Let's bring Mama back around as Summer blazes by on Smokey. Here comes the running man. Watch her feet moving in perfect sync with her pony today. Big, long strides around the Dean C. Jackson. How about it for Summer? Emmy and Shorty stealing the show with a sit-down fender. Right there. hanging on to the side with just one hand, giving a fist bump around to the VIPs. Waving to the crowd on a Sunday afternoon, how do you like an eight-year-old today? Little sister Jensen, back around, spinning the horn. Right around from the saddle to the neck. Spin the horn back in position we go. As Glam takes her in front of the president's box today. How about it on a Sunday afternoon for Jensen Boy?
Now Miss Summer gets back into action. She's gonna spin around the horn and then bump back in the saddle. One more time right there in front of the president's box. And right in front of the grandstands, give it up for Summer. Emmy says, all right, Mom, I see what you got going on. Show you how they used to do it when they were carrying the mail. Here's the Pony Express Vault. The chummy little pony keeps rolling right along. One more time. Good job, Miss Emmy. Now Jensen shows you the reverse neck layover. As Glam brings that little five-year-old all the way around the arena. Friends, if you like what you've seen so far, let's give one more round of applause to Summer and Company.
You know, in a theme of family, tradition, and heritage, and traveling as one, we bring them back around. Here comes Mama with the Hippodrome. The one-foot stand as she makes her way around. Now, we change it over. There is the one-foot stand flying around at EMC Jackson today. We do it as a family. As we welcome little Emmy and Shorty, here come our variation and our attempt at the Hippodrome. I love the fist bump. Coming all the way around, saying hello to the very top of our VIP portals today. And a standing ovation from President Nygren. Here comes Jensen. Last but not least, the five-year-old. And her steed called Glam. Trying to get everything going. There we go. You know, anything can happen in a live production. There we go. Now, we do it with a little pride on Sunday afternoon. Bringing them to speed, here comes five-year-old Jensen and Old Glory with no hands around the Dean C. Jackson Memorial Arena today. Once again, if you're proud of the red, white, and blue in our Western heritage, make a little noise for the Boy family.
That is Mom Summer. 8-year-old Emmy and 5-year-old Jensen from Lovington, New Mexico. Summer Boy and family, the Trick Riding Cowgirls.
What an awesome display. A big thank you to them for joining us.
Comes in with a 32-38. She had a half-second lead on the field. Gracie, let's keep them all standing. Big Bay Horse around the first. Changes lead, switches hands. Long stride and Bay, come on back to the rest. Crossing that timeline, 16-15. Give it up for the ladies.
Devin Batoni. Easing our way down the alley today. Coming to us on a 32-92. Anything can happen on a Sunday. Let's ride in with an INFR qualifier as we go across to the Navajo Parks and Rec Barrel 2 right now. Oh! We take it down, make our way around number 3 and run on home today. Total time could be a 21-61.
Donalia, Arizona, Sierra Farland. Sierra coming in at a blaze of glory. wide around that first barrel. Try and tighten up around the second. Third barrel, that's what we were looking for.
I'm sexy, I know it.
We will stop it. 17-31 for Sierra.
Does a gold buckle combined for this performance. We ride in with Justine Doka. One of our top all-around cowgirls holds one in the breakaway as she zooms around in the barrel race. Parks and Rec barrel number two. Justine, gonna take that one down as we slide around number three. And our total time is gonna be 21 and 5.9 for Justine. 21.
It's your time to award our Resist All Fan of the Afternoon, brought to you by the Navajo Nation and Raptor G Rodeo.
I'm telling you, I don't know where to go with this because I know she's been wanting it all week long. I gave it to your grandpa? Oh.
All right, wait a minute.
Who wants the hat? Okay, wait a minute. I've got to do something. And I was sitting over here talking with this guy earlier. He looks like an Indian Willie Nelson. So, this has been one of my best friends over here on this side. Will you stand up just a little bit? Take that hat off. Let me see this Willie Nelson hair. That's awesome, just whipping around. I have got to do this for this man right here. What's your name?
There you go.
What's your name? Marshall. That's like not an Indian name.
like Marshall Tucker. I like
that's
it.
That's like Marshall Tucker. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Listen, do you come to rodeos very often?
Every now and then. Okay, well, guess what? You're Raptor G, Resist All's fan of the night. You got to get on there. I know you said you're going to give it to this guy. But listen, if you give it to him, you gotta come use it every now and then. Will that work? All right. Give it up for my Indian, Willie Nelson Marshall.
Pattern is set. Arena smoothed out, ready to go. See if he has got all the right moves. So far she does. Picks up the second barrel. Now, come on, Window Rock, you ride with her. 16:42 will put her into contention. Give her a chance at moving forward into the final.
Now, who comes to us on a 33-47? Chitley, Arizona. We need to hear from the Chitley Crazies one time. Feel like Chitley's been pretty quiet today. Here's a cowgirl we've seen qualify for India National Finals Rodeo with the Great Jones family, a breakaway rope and barrel racer. On her way to number three, everybody scream! And our time today is going to be a 16:62. That'll put her.
We now have four cowgirls, smooth on three as well. Paige Dale of Shiprock, New Mexico. It's all about trying to beat the clock. The sun starts to come out. Reins on the left side of the horse. Pull it around. Let's go. 16:80 for Paige. Going it maybe just a touch too long.
Let's go to Alicia Paul, Mishpato, Arizona. In and around number one on our way to Parks and Rec barrel number two. All right, Alicia. We need a little help from the grandstand right here. Oh. No. And a 5-second penalty puts her at a 21-94. Banners of the Navajo Nation Gaming Enterprise and Navajo Parks and Rec.
And ready. How many bull riding fans do we have in Window Rock? to the final four. And then it will be our Calcutta and the bonus round. While we've got a chance, we take you to the Sun Construction Bucket Shoot with Flagstaff, Arizona's Melton Curling. The ball underneath him comes from Rudy Vanna. This is Shelby. That's right, he's got a bull named Shelby.
I had a girlfriend named Shelby. That's about it.
She wasn't a bull, was she?
Nope.
Oh, okay.
Looked like her.
Melton Curly. Can he make a qualified run? Try to move on.
Whoa, don't mess with Shelby. Get up and out of there.
Melton gets in a bad way, and there are two men that step in to make sure that he can walk away. Those are your bullfighters. Let's give it up for Austin Rudloff and Cade Parks.
Well, they call him Slick. Comes from Porcupine, South Dakota. On a bull called Tin Cup, Rudy Vila, bringing us the bull power. We're inside shoot number 5-6 right now. Navajo Shopping Centers Incorporated. If I had a dollar for every time I did that this week. Thank you to the New Mexico State Police. JoinNMSP.com. Sponsoring shoot number 8 all week long. There you see the glove of a two-time champion of the world in the Indian National Finals Rodeo. Taking our final round before we slide up, call for the bull today. He comes to us on a no score, one of our random drawbacks, looking to move on, as you heard Andy say. He's got the talent, the ability, and definitely the bull power. Tin Cup, Slick Phelps, let's get a bull ride. There we go. Come on, Slick. Find your groove. Oh, direction change. And a thumbs up today. How about a qualified bull ride in Window Rock? We get the numbers in. 68 points for Slick.
Navajo Engineering Construction Authority Bucket Shoot, Brad Marino. Casa Grande, Arizona. Gringo, the name of the bull. And he ain't playing. Yeah, locally, I think you guys would call that Billigana, right? Is that?
Nice.
See, I'm telling you, we're keeping Andy's
side. Yeah, I told him.
Me? I don't know about that. I can't speak Navajo at all.
Yeah, we found that out yesterday. Let's go to JB, Colorado, with Page, Arizona. Rudy Villas, Collusion, the name of the bull. Now, we've seen JB be 74 already this week. Oh, yeah. He's looking to ride his second one today. How about it for JB, Colorado? He was hyped last night as he's a 73 today, 147 on 2.
Great job making a ride on the butt-headed pasture. Sun Construction Bucket Shoot, Gallup, New Mexico's Odie Tom, an INFR qualifier. Another Rudy available, this is Grenade. Thank you again to our camera and stats crew. Keeping us Johnny on the spot, taking you inside the bucket chute so that you can see the final moments. The cowboy tries to gather everything up. See if he can make a bull ride. You can do it, no! Comes over the front end and slaps the bull. No score for Odie.
Old school rodeo looking bull already gave Jester a tap. Saying who's next?
Where are you going? You're moving your mobile home to another?
Let's go to Benj Bateau, Arizona, as we ride with a cowboy who's been on fire over the last few years. You see him in the PBR and the PRCA, and he is in the hunt for a Navajo Nation Fair title. Jacoy Hale is ready to ride inside chute number 6 from Navajo Nation Shopping Centers Incorporated. Blaze of Glory from Rivera, taking him northbound on a Sunday afternoon. How do you like Jacoy Hale today?
I want you to watch the very end of this ride. Watch how close this bull gets to our judge, Travis Howe. He literally gets cow poop on his jeans because the bull hits him next to the fence. The numbers come together. I think Travis is going to enter his score last. Right there. Almost mucks out the judge. Okay. For Jacoy Hale, he's got 2 down.
Let's go to a former champion of this rodeo. We've seen him ride 2 for 2. We've seen him win the bonus round. Andy Sells of Tuba City, Arizona. He's got Magnum from Rudy Vila. By the way, Jacoy is 145. As we are inside chute number 3, let's do it with Andy in the Pendleton bucket chute. Ouch! Ouch!
The bull, oh, takes one more look around, just reminding everybody who's the boss. We try to get him out the Enchantment Physical Therapy Center alleyway.
You know where he goes?
Where?
Anywhere he wants to.
That's right. I promise you. Here comes Wyatt Petone. Oh, that hurts for his chances at an all-round title. As the spotted bull Brimstone gets him down to the ground. A no score for Wyatt Petone. Seven on a pair. He is your champion bull rider. Let's give him a big round of applause for winning it and advancing to the final 4.
Thanking our partners at CKP Insurance and the Navajo Nation Fair, ringing around the banners as we get ready to go to the Calcutta down below. We hope you've been paying attention. Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation. Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department brings it to you as we start off today in the steer wrestling. This is one of our Calcutta events, a total of $620 in the pot in the Calcutta alone. But in the actual steer wrestling competition, $2,000 winner take all. The rodeo has been decided. We've awarded our champions. We've crowned our champions, if you will. We will do the award saddle presentation after the bonus round today. Johnny Jones gonna start us off. It's a clean slate format, winner take all. Oklahoma City, Oklahoma talent, in my opinion, was an absolute steal in the Calcutta. He rides in the gunner in our showdown round today.
Timers are good, judges are in position. It is time to see who gets the $2,000 bonus. Double J backs the sorrel horse in the corner, setting the pace for everyone else to follow. The man on a football Sunday that looks like a live horse gets down and over him. But the $40 wager will come up to nothing in no time. It's a long ways back to Oklahoma City. Let Johnny Jones know we're going to ride with him. We want him to come back.
Oh boy. The D.C. Jackson Memorial Arena. He finished out 3rd overall in the rodeo, but we shake it off. We throw all that out the door. Clean slate, winner take all. You see Truman back it in, cool, calm, collect. Looking to be the first qualified time in the bonus round today. Calling for it, gets caught up. Oh, makes the jump, hits the ground, and in no time we're 0-for-2, Andy Seiler.
But I have all the faith in the world that it's right in Muskogee, Oklahoma. He will be the next cowboy to go. The long, tall drink of water from the center of our country will ride the big bay horse in to try and do what he's been doing all week long. Throw steers with a sense of aggression and speed. Fulbright gets that barrier line strung up behind him. Choctaw Cowboy. trying to take the nest egg from the Navajo Nation. Watch as the cowboy settles in. Easy there, Bay. Want to get the hazen horse set and ready.
When the pressure's as high as it is now, you see the hair trigger situation. Now, imagine you had everything ready. False start, reset. Get your ducks back in a row. No qualified times turned in. The cowboy from the Choctaw Nation wants $2,000 to take home. Mind right. Get your start. Get your money. Treviante, let's go right there. And a 4-5 sets the pace for the Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation bonus round.
Now we have something for Matthew Jody. Will it be Oklahoma or New Mexico to take the biggest check in the steer wrestling? Family affair. As he has his sister, Caden, doing the hazing duties. It's 4.4, or Fulbright gets the lion's share of the cash. This is a man that understands his format. He has won the final four in the past. Can he do it again? He resets the black horse. Out there for the white steer. Turn him around. Oh, 4/10 of a second too slow. Needed to be 4.4. He's going to be 4.8. That means your champion from Muskogee, Oklahoma, from the Choctaw Nation. Let's give it up for Treviante Fulbright.
Taking the victory lap behind our partners in the Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department of the Navajo Nation Fair, bringing us the final. We're going to kick it off today with a former champion of this rodeo who's also won the final four showdown round. Again, it's a clean slate, winner take all. And in my opinion, your bareback riders were an absolute steal.
Indeed they were. And this has got to be a good horse because his name's Andy. Whistle Joe of Round Rock, Arizona. Raptor G draw underneath him. In the Navajo Nation Shopping Center Bucket Shoot. Whistle Joe sets the pace. Nod of the hand, let's go. Big sorrel horse. Whistle Joe makes it to the whistle.
A great way to finish strong. To the wee Cadillac Whistle Joe today. Half the score for the horse, half the score for the great Andy. As the numbers come in today, 77, Whistle Joe sets the pace. Andy's got that wild local energy.
That's right. Totally in Arizona's Wyatt Petone. We saw an Oklahoma man win the steer wrestling. Here's a horse with some Oklahoma roots. Tulsa time.
Oh, yes. Strong knockout, taking a turn with the feet. And in trouble we go. Thankfully, our hand pops out. And it's going to be a no score today for the Totally a Cowboys. You watch the replay. Big stick right there. And just kind of tried to keep it going, tried to find a timing, rhythm, and momentum. But unfortunately, not in the cards on a Sunday afternoon. Taking a clean out of it. Let's keep one more time as we go out of our champion physical therapy outgate. You know, a grueling rodeo this is, from Wednesday to Sunday, 5 huge days of competition. Enchantment Physical Therapy doing a great job keeping our cowboys and cowgirls in tip-top shape for competition. Matthew Tooney of Denahoto, Arizona is the sleeper in the round. Memory maker from Raptor G. He's a college national finalist as we get ready to buck him out of shoot number 3 today. Pendleton Woolen Mills bringing us the matchup. Your high score so far, the only one turned in, is a 77-point rise. Matthew Tooney, looking to rise to the occasion on a Sunday afternoon, looking to be in the 80s. How many Matthew Tooney fans are ready to ride in Window Rock? Oh! We're going to safety up at the end of the ride. No score today.
Coming in. 64. 64 will not be enough for Tootie.
All right, Juanita's Grill and Gloria West, we need you over to see Nadine Claw ASAP. Juanita's Grill, Gloria West, over to Nadine Claw, right by Navajo Parks and Rec Portal. Thank you.
Final cowboy to go in the bareback ride, Tonalea, Arizona's Evan Batoni. He has been dominant up to this point. 78 points if he wants to win the $2,000 bonus next to Era Energy Bucket Shoot. CB, the name of the horse from Raptor G. Can we get up into the 80s?
Oh, I'm liking this so far. Come on, back to the center. Oh, Evan clawing his way to that 8-second mark. Oh, and no scores. We missed him out. No score today. So that means in your final four showdown, 77 points. Whistle Joe will win the cash. $2,000 from Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department. Oh, Andy.
Navajo Nation Fair. Navajo Nation Parks and Rec bringing you our Sunday Shootout.
What an exciting day. You know, you buy a ticket to Sunday afternoon. This is why. The excitement, the energy, the atmosphere is on the line. Garrison Nez, one of our legendary talents in Indian professional rodeo, still going down the road today. Clean slate format. First gunner riding in. No pressure whatsoever. Set the pace, drinking our mouth, open our hands, looking at another run in the practice field. Set in the corner, start clean, be fast, be smooth. Little red calf, down to the 1/3 mark of the arena. Come on, Garrison. There we go. Whoop, whoop. Not quite the flank we wanted. String and back on track and a 16-6 and a 10 at the barrier, not the way you want
in the house. Gavaro Harrison next to go, just a smooth run to set the pace. Watch and wait for Noah and Dante. Big buckskin horse backs into the corner. Stop the clock, penalty free, no mistakes. Right down the center of the arena. Now, watch. He puts the spring around all three. 12-9. 12-9. He takes a step forward. Now we need 6 seconds to make sure it becomes official. And it will. 12-9. Now your number one time.
That is the time to beat as we go to Noah Hayes. There's a young gun talent that has put on quite a display at the Navajo Nation Fair in 2023. Big thank you again, our partners at Crown Enterprise, Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company. Parks and Recreation Department bringing us the Final Four Showdown round. There you see that young man who's been chasing the INFR Tour in 2023. Willing to get things set. Shrug it off. 12-9, the time to beat. You know he's after it. Little black calf blazing down the arena. Oh, and a Hail Mary not going to connect. Going to be a no time here on Sunday afternoon.
That is the fastest calf I've seen all day.
Yeah.
I think
he's been in the driver's seat from go round one up until the title that he just claimed.
It's
12-8 is easy pickings for the Tulsa, Oklahoma Cowboy. But as he backs the horse in the corner, it's one thing to talk about it, it's another thing to do it. And he makes a clean sweep of the tie-down ropers. He's got him captured. Now watch. The groundwork has been impeccable, and it stays that way. As he remounts, takes one step forward, he is penalty free, and the closest champ for two more, 8.2, and he's $2,000 richer.
You talk about the exclamation mark on the Navajo Nation Fair, 8.2. Been the fastest run of the entire rodeo this week. How about it, your Final Four Showdown Round champion, Dontre Goff. Thank you, Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department of the Navajo Nation Fair. $2,000 richer. Don't forget to end the official awards presentations on the arena floor following the Showdown Round.
With my way, the lady, Renelle Sellis, Chimney, Arizona. $100 cowgirl in the cow cutter competition. Backing him in the corner. Yes, it will fit. 3.7. 3-7 for Renell.
What a way to start it off. Ooh, we got a Tohatchee, New Mexico right now. You know her, Cassidy Dennison. The Wrangler National Finalist and 9-time champion of the world. Carrying on the great family legacy. In the DMC Jackson Arena, yes! Makes it look easy in a 3.4. She goes to the lead in the round. We're one step closer to a $2,000 paycheck.
Flagstaff, Arizona wants their part of the action. Serena DeHosey. 3-4 is now the time to top. $440. That is the bounty that they paid to have Serena go to the top. Oh, no. That investment will not pay off. That's a great cowgirl in your arena. Come on, Window Rock. Make her feel at home.
That brings us to our final over half a second. But again, it's clean slate. We got to be faster than a 3.4. If we want to take a $2,000 payday to Totalia, Arizona. The young gun, Autumn Farland, is in pursuit of a bonus round title. No penalties, and a 3-flat for $2,000. What an experience. As you see the excitement on her face, how about it for Autumn Farland today?
These are the moments and memories that will last you a lifetime, Autumn, as we bring in the banners of Navajo Nation Parks and Rec and the Navajo Nation Fair. Let's give one more round of applause to Autumn Farland.
$954 off of a $240 investment in the Calcutta.
If only I could have hit that at Fire Rock. Bucket shoot, Lyle Thomas, the horse's citation. But he will not make it to the whistle. Sorrel Horse.
I'm wishing better luck down the road. He's about as banged up as being at a state line dance, but he's okay. He's okay. Let's go to Stayed Ribs right now. Tuba City, Arizona. Sundance from Rafter G. We're inside chute number 6 from our partners at the Navajo Nation Shopping Centers Incorporated. We've seen this cowboy all over North America. You got to watch him at the College National Finals Rodeo. The Riggs boys can ride some bucking horses. The prime example right here is we look to get some money with Stay. Sundance. And the Tuba City kid ready to go to work in the Dean C. Jackson Memorial Arena. Come on, Stade. Go win some money. Oh, yeah. Look at this. Flashy. Doing his job. Yeah. To the safety of the pickup end of the arena floor we go. How do you like Stade Rear? 77 gonna set the pace in your bonus round today. 77.
Elk Arizona had to be licking his chops when he saw his name next to this horse. Mission Bells. Navajo Engineering Construction Authority bucket chute. If he does his job and does it well, 77 should be no problem.
You know, he's one of those young gun talents that came to change the guard, if you will. We saw him win the White Mountain Apache Tribal Fair last week. He's in Window Rock now, looking to get some bonus money.
Horse kicking high and hard out the back. But we got some bad news. A yellow flag on the ground. Watch the right foot. It fell down. It was not above the horse's shoulder. It'll be a no score for Shane Phillips. No score.
Ooh, what a tough go at it. Your bonus round, Andy, we're 0 for 2. With shoot number 3 we go. Pendleton Woolen Mills, the one, the only CC rider. The now back-to-back champion of the Navajo Nation Fair in the Navajo Pearl Anniversary. Black Betty of Rafter G. Fun. Saying yande on a Sunday, how do you like CC Rider? Oh. How about an 87 point ride? Look at the extension of the replay. Textbook. Beautiful. That's why we come on a Sunday afternoon, Andy Seiler.
Indeed, Mike. The bonus round to the victor go the spoils for that 87-point ride. Congratulations again to the world champ, and now the back-to-back Navajo Nation Open Rodeo champ, Brayton Burley. We will take you back to the time and end of the arena after we fly the flag of the Navajo Nation Fair and the Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department. It is the ladies team roping. Mackley Williams and Alicia Key.
Who gets you going? I don't know what to tell you. Williams and Key, a pair of cowgirls from Holbrook. This is where the heat's up. There you go. Good to hear everybody having fun as they call for it. Now in the left we go. Come on. There it is. No penalties on the run, and a 9-3 will set the pace.
Arizona. Cowgirls from the big city. coming to the middle of the Navajo Nation. Backing in a pair of sorrels. Good steer. We got the front end captured. We need 2 feet for a clean run. That'll no time for Destiny and Resenda.
From the land of enchantment, Kylie Gilbert, Farmington, New Mexico, rides in on the head side. Lene Willie of Magdalena, back her up on the heels. Carrying on the great Gilbert family legacy. Indian professional rodeo. We look for Lene. Got me a little nervous up here.
Yeah, she backed in the corner. I thought she was going to nod by herself.
Yeah, that's what I was waiting. I was like, she's going to try this?
Talk about being zoned in.
Uh-huh.
I was going to say, you know, Kylie's cowboy enough to do both in the same role. I wouldn't put it past her. Here we go. Gilbert on the head side. Down in the left we go. Willie, give us 2 right there. Yeah. Oh. Head horse don't want to face. There it is. Drop the flag at a 12-9.
A legend and a champion on the head side. A world champion. A young up-and-comer on the heels. There's the horns. 2 feet for $2,000. And it will not work out. So the first team to go in the championship round, Mackley Williams and Alicia Key, will take the bonus.
Behind the banner of the Navajo Nation Fair and Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department, here they come with a 9-3, Mackley Williams, Alicia Key. Outstanding run as we go to arguably the fan favorite event at the Navajo Nation Fair. It's time for the team roping. Boy, coming all the way from the northwest on the heel side of Port Defiance, Arizona, Brooks DeHosey. It'll be team number 1. Carrying on 2 great family legacies, 2 mainstay talents. When you look at the years of the Indian National Finals Rodeo, they've got multiple qualifications under their belts as they bring that to Window Rock, Arizona.
I just love this shootout format because there's no question as to who the champion is. It is pure black and white. Fastest time, best ride, that's your champ. Justin Tom doing the head catching duties. Brooks DeHosey spins around on the buckskin. 2 horns, 2 feet, gentlemen. That is what we are looking for. Justin nods. Oh, that's Brooks on the head side. My apologies.
Oh, man. Simon and Tyler Sam, Tuba City, Arizona. Chin Lee. Where are the Chin Lee crazies at one more time? Always love hearing from them. Norman and Sam ride in pursuit of the bonus money. Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department proud to bring it to you today. With the 7 wonders of Navajo land, from the beauty of Monument Valley, Veterans Memorial Park. They've got so much to offer. We look to get Tolman and Sam to the winner's circle today. Cool little smile. We look to nod on a Sunday afternoon. Get some money, boys. Get some money. In there that says we can't try to fish it off because you never know what will happen on a Sunday.
No time, Yazzie. Brimhall in Coyote Canyon, New Mexico. Dennis, doing the horn catching duties. Hi-o, the all-around cowboy in the college national finals qualifier. Stop the clock and you will be in the driver's seat. There is the head catch. Hi-o! 7-9. 7-9 as they will now keep our final team honest.
You know, there's a cool video on Facebook of Hi-o Yazzie giving Dave
Doyle Yazzie and Victor Begay.
The number one team to finish out the nomination fair, and we saw them win the title already. Let's put the exclamation mark on it right here, right now.
Well, and just to confuse you even more, Yazzie and Begay are trying to beat Begay and Yazzie.
Here we go. Doyle, Victor, give us two like you do, yeah!
And a 5.8, your bonus round champions. Watch it on the replay. Victor scooping in like a Hall of Famer. You bet.
I thought Doyle was staring me down, but he was watching himself on the replay board. And they go behind the banner of the Navajo Nation Fair. And Navajo Nation Parks and Rec, give it up one more time for Doyle Yazzie and Victor Begay.
Proudly represented Arizona all through her high school career, now in the college rodeo. She has gone to some of the biggest events around Arizona, New Mexico, chasing the tour as well. She's got the first run to make in the bonus round. Navajo Parks and Rec Barrel looking good. Yeah, 2 for 2 so far. Window Rock, send her home now. And a 16-16 will put her in the lead right now.
Shilson. 16-15 is what we need to take the lead. Come on, Mia. A side pass to get tied. Slick move gives way to two more. And she's 16-66, just a little too long.
The famous Chin Lee Crazy. Help Aaron ease our way down that alley. Set our sights, cross the timeline, and build speed to number one. Great 360 left-hand turn. Number two looking better. All right, Arizona, help her run right here. Round three smooth, and the time going to be a 16-69.
Dale, final cowgirl to try it out. 16-15, or that's it. New Mexico cowgirl gets by the second. Come on, let's go, Paige. 1686.
Gracie Alcott going to be a clean, taking the rodeo, taking the final four showdown, and an absolute steal. Getting her buyer $1,080, I believe, as we bring her around in style by the banners of the Navajo Nation Fair, Navajo Parks and Recreation Department. Winslow, Arizona's Gracie Alcott.
How many of you on a Sunday ready to win? Anderson Sells, Tuba City, Arizona. The bull is called Outlaw.
We will rock you.
Come on, Andy!
That's pretty.
Yeah, right.
It's pretty until it gets inside your barrel.
Either that or he stay over there. He's much, much prettier over there, I promise.
Yeah, yeah.
Out you go. See you later.
Now, don't forget our awards presentations. Those beautiful Caskey saddles go to our champions today, immediately following the bull riding. Totally Arizona, Wyatt Petone, on a bull from Stace Smith called Cell Phone. Shoot number 5 is where we take you to Sunt Bucking Shoot today. Wyatt Petone on his way for the all-around title at the Navajo Nation Fair. Now we're riding for some bonus dollars. Presented by the Navajo Parks and Recreation Department. Cell phone. Wyatt's had a long week between the bareback and the bull riding. But you can bet he's going to rise to the occasion on a Sunday. As your bullfighters get in to draw the attention away, as Wyatt's able to get away safely, going to be a no score as we say a big thank you to your bullfighters one more time, Austin.
Now to the pack side of the bucket shoots, shoot number 3, Pendleton Woolen Mills. And the 21-year-old that's in the top 50 in professional rodeo, the up-and-coming star, Jacoy Hale of Ganado, Arizona. The bull is called Chumanji. He pulls that rope tight. Looking to be the first man to make the 8-second whistle in our 4-round.
Let's hope the Jumanji magic works in his favor here on a Sunday afternoon. Andy, we're 0-2 so far. We need to get a bull ride.
I like our chances here. Jacoy, a talented young man with the moxie and the belief that he can get the job done. The only thing left to do is go accomplish that feat. Slides up over the right hand.
$2,000 on the line. You got to make sure everything is perfect. I got to see his beautiful grandparents before the rodeo today. Where's Team BBT sitting at? Besh Patel, Arizona in the house. A strong rodeo family. I'd like to take a moment, say hello to our now former Miss Navajo Nation, Valentina Klitso, in the skyboxes with us today. Give her a big round of applause and a thank you for a job well done. She served as Miss Navajo Nation all year and handed over the title last time. Thank you so much, Valentina.
Hey, you guys have been awesome. Just saying. Just wanted you to know that.
Just, I mean, tell them. You don't like those announcers right there, yeah? Come on, give it up for them, yeah?
Jacoy! Oh! Boy, coming down.
Yeah, that means it comes down to JB Colorado. The bull is called Tsunami. That's something that doesn't happen very often right here on the Navajo Nation. But let's see if we can create a storm of our own. JB, stay right there. Come on, let me hear it. We are looking to our judges. We got a thumbs up. He made it. You know what? Some people might call that one a layup, but you still got to make the shot. 76 points for JB.
Wow. $2,000 on a 76-point bull ride. How about it for JB Colorado one more time? As we say thank you to the Navajo Nation Fair and Navajo Nation Parks and Recreation Department.
Friends, please stick around. We will have our award ceremony here in just a little bit. And all of you contestants,